Hello, Deshler Middle School students. Mrs. Sockwell here, and I have Mr. Keelan Walker, owner of Keelan Walker Photography. He is a former student of Mr. Graham's from Florence High School, and Mr. Graham reached out to me and said, hey, he was supposed to come last year, couldn't make it. Could you interview him this time? And I was like, yeah, of course I can, totally, because I love photography. Photography is a hobby of mine, and I love to see what photographers can capture through their lens and through their mind's eye as well. So, Mr. Keelan Walker, thank you for being with us today. Would you please tell us the academic pathway that kind of led you to where you are?
Yes, thank you for having me. So, like she said, my name is Keelan, and I own a full-service portrait studio in Florence, Alabama. So, we specialize in newborn, first-year milestones, and weddings. Specializing in that kind of came a little bit later on down the road. But I started as early as middle school doing photography. So I was involved in TSA and a few other school programs that I was allowed to be the historian. So I was able to photograph different school activities. And then I picked up a camera at home, pursued curiosity. And then so people started reaching out to me and wanted me to photograph them. So what I did was I started practicing with like family members, neighbors, then church members reached out. And then from there, I realized I probably should start learning about this because it was totally new to me. Portraits were new to me as well. So I did some online classes. I shadowed other photographers. I did workshops. And then when I got into high school, there was an awesome photography class I was able to be a part of. And that taught me a lot. And then from there, I just purchased workshops and then trial and error. So that's basically how I got in and kind of how I learned. And of course, the more that you do something, the better you become at it. So just practicing what I've learned from different teachers and classes.
Okay, so these online classes that you spoke of in workshops, they're not necessarily through a university or through a community college or something like that. They're offered through various computer software programs. Am I right in assuming that? Or where can a student go to find these?
Yes. Yeah, so there's actually creativelive.com is where I learned a lot of things. And especially this time, they've got a lot of free classes going on because schools are closed. So you can go there, access free classes. You can actually search things that you want to learn about, purchase classes. They have a lot of really good sales. So I've learned a lot from there. YouTube is great. There's a lot of free resources there. So I recommend like getting on YouTube and just researching different things and learning that way as well.
Okay. And for these classes and workshops, there's not an age requirement or anything like that. It's kind of like you pay your money and you can participate, or do you have to be a certain age?
That I don't know. I'm sure you could just pay, or you could have your parents pay, right? You know, if they're not old enough to do it. So
right.
Definitely talk with your parents at home and see if they can look into it for you.
Okay. So what are some soft skills that you use day to day with your clients? Everyone that I've spoken with, you know, has really touched base on communication skills, listening skills. I know that in photography, you kind of have to be really quick with your deadlines. You have to make sure that you're organized and you don't overbook yourself. So can you just hit on some of those and what you use day to day?
Yes. So we are really, really, communication is key with us. Like, that's a top priority. I have two other ladies that work at the studio, so it makes communicating a lot easier with people. But I mean, from the booking process to delivering the final images, we are on top of it. We educate our clients on what to expect because a lot of our clients are first-time moms. A lot of our clients are first-time brides. So being able to like provide them with resources and information just really upsets the client experience that we try to provide. So communication is very important. Being organized is very important because you need to know where files are, where client information is at, like backing up images, different things like that. So communication, organization are two really huge, huge components to what we do.
Okay, that sounds great. Is there any kind of words of advice that you could give our students beyond the online classes, beyond, organizations and stuff like that? Is there anything that you just kind of want to leave with our kids as far as words of advice, words of wisdom?
Yes. So the key with anything photography is an art. So just get out there, have fun with it. Find something that you enjoy. And as long as you enjoy it, that's all that matters. If you want to take it the next step to make it a business or whatever, then of course you can, reach back out and learn different things about how the business side works or how to do it. But the key thing is if you enjoy it, just do it for the enjoyment and have fun with it.
Okay. And I actually just happened to think of one more question. So you are a photographer who specializes in weddings and newborns and things like that, but how many, I guess, categories of a photographer could you be, or do you have to own your own business? Are there places that, you know, have photographers, like, for example, newspapers and stuff? Like, do you know of any that, you know, these kids may not want to own their own business, but maybe they could work for a company one day? Is there anything like that?
Yes, there is. So there's different genres of photography that you can do. And when I started out, I was everything, you know, I did seniors, I did landscape, I did whatever until I decided that I wanted to be known for something. But there's different things to do if you want to, you know, branch out and do that yourself. If you want to work for someone, there is a great business in town called IKP, Images Kept. And they're actually a sports photography business, but they do hire high school students to photograph sports. And they had asked if I wanted to do it when I was in high school, but it just didn't work out with my schedule. So maybe if you're wanting to, like, get in there and learn about the camera, see what it's about, maybe you can reach out to them and see if they're still offering spots.
Okay. That sounds awesome.
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Walker, thank you so much for taking time out of your day. Kids, like I mentioned, photography is the hobby of mine. I'm definitely not a professional, but I feel confident that if you do want to pursue this path, that Mr. Walker will be happy to answer any of your questions. And Mr. Graham is a direct connect to him, or I can as well. But thank you again, Mr. Walker, for your time. And we appreciate you capturing moments for us. Thank you.
Yes, thank you for having me.